students, welcome back to e-class of Max. It's our third chapter, and in first chapter we have discussed all about rational numbers. Then in the second chapter we have discussed about linear equation in one variable, how to solve these all things we have studied in that classes, isn't it? Now we are going to study about the quadrilaterals, understanding the quadrilaterals. For that we are going to study about, first of all we are studying curves. What is a curve? A plane curve is a curve that lies in a single plane or a plane surface like paper. What is a plane? Plane, for example, this board is a plane, the paper you are writing is a plane, or any board, it is a plane, the floor, it is a plane. When it comes board and floor together, it does not become a plane. When it is only one thing, then it is a plane. Then what is a plane curve? The line drawn on a line means maybe rough line or straight line. Anything drawn on a straight line on a plane, that becomes a plane curve. A plane curve may be closed or open. A plane curve can be closed or open. These are some examples of curves. You may see that, how can we draw it? A simple curve that we draw here that forms a, this is a curve, and when it is a closed curve, when we draw it like this, then it becomes a closed curve. These are all about a curve, a plane curve, a closed curve and an open curve. Then next we are going to study about polygons. Then we have discussed all about curves. Now we are discussing about line segment. Those line segments join together to form a closed thing that is known as polygon. Then how many here? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 lines are there. They combine together to form a closed one, and it is nothing but it is a polygon. Now we are, in this chapter we are dealing with quadrilateral. It is also a polygon. It joins with number of sides. Then with it, the number of sides, we can name it to different names. Okay, first of all, parts of a polygon. You know that you have studied it in the earlier classes, but again, just for your information, the end points of the sides of a polygon are called vertices. What is the vertices? These B, C, D, these all are the vertices. When naming a polygon, its vertices are named in the consecutive order, either clockwise or counterclockwise. What does it mean? It should be named such that if I am naming this quadrilateral, I can name it as A, B, C, D, quadrilateral A, B, C, D, or I can name it as B, C, D, A, or I can name it as D, A, B, C, or I can name it as C, B, A, D. That is, it should be clockwise or anticlockwise when we are naming the quadrilateral. You cannot name it as A, B, D, C. This is the difference. Okay. Then consecutive sides are two sides that have an endpoint in common. What is the consecutive side? Then AB and AD. These are the consecutive sides. That means they come together to form a common endpoint. These are the consecutive sides. The four sides of a polygon in figure below could can have been named ABCD. This I have told you. ABCD, BCDA, ADCB. For example, it does not matter with which letter you begin, as long as the vertices are named consecutively. Sides AB and BC are examples for consecutive, that I have explained earlier. Then it doesn't matter, I should only name ABCD. I can name it as AEBC. Also I can be named it. It doesn't matter what letter I have given in the vertices. It doesn't matter. You should only take this on the clockwise order. When you are beginning from B, then B, C, B, A. Then if you are in the anti-clockwise order, that is B, A, B, C. This is the thing. Then Now next we are going for the other part. It is known as diagonal. Familiar name is that diagonal. Then what is the diagonal? A diagonal of a polygon is a segment that joins two non-consecutive vertices. What is consecutive? Then P and U are consecutive. Then non-consecutive, what are non-consecutive? T and U are non-consecutive. Then figure shows five-sided polygon Q, R, S, T, U. This is a five-sided polygon and it has the name as Q, R, S, T, U. Then Q, S is a diagonal. Then Q and S are non-consecutive and when line runs from this point to this one, it becomes the diagonal. Here R and P are non-consecutive. Then again line drawn from here to here, again becomes the diagonal. These are all about diagonal. Then this is a five-sided polygon, which is already said. Then how many number of diagonals it have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, you know? It have 5 diagonals. Then how can we count, how can calculate the number of diagonals each polygon should have? This you have studied in earlier classes. Again I am repeating. Number of diagonal is equal to n into n minus 3 by 2. This is the equation to find number of diagonals in a polygon. Then what is n? N is the number of sides of the polygon. Here you can see that this is a five-sided polygon. Then if we are having 5 numbers, then number of polygons will be n here to here 5. Then if we substitute this equation, what will become 5 into 5 minus 3 divided by 2. Okay, na? Then 5 into 5 minus 3. 5 minus 3 it will get 2. 2 into 5, 10. 10 divided by 2 is 5. Then how many number of polygons are diagonals are there? 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Equal okay, na? This the way to find the number of diagonals in a polygon. Then next thing, we are going to classify these polygons. How can we classify? The main classification is not convex and concave, or convex or not convex. This is the first classification. Then we can classify it in the number of sides it is possessing. Then first we have, a polygon is concave if there are two points somewhere inside a four, which a segment with these as its endpoints cuts at least two of the sides of the polygon. It seems to be a complicated definition. If you are not able to study this one, you can have the another definition. This is there in your textbook. Then this is the another simple definition that you can study for concave. In a simple form, those polygon have at least one interior angle greater than 180 degree. Then that becomes the concave polygon. If a polygon having at least one interior angle, then next thing ho gaya, what is interior angle, what is exterior angle? This is a polygon. You can see that in this polygon, this is the another polygon. Then here comes, this is the interior angle of this polygon. This is the interior, one interior angle. This is the another interior angle. This is the another. These all are interior angles, isn't it? Then from that, you can see that these all angles are less than 180 degree. This is the only angle that is greater than 180 degree. Then here it becomes a concave polygon. Okay. Then next one, it is the another thing, that quadrilateral. In this one you can see that this is a exterior interior angle, these are interior angles, and the other one, this is also a interior angle. Then this is the another interior angle. Then these all interior angles are less than 180 degree. Then here comes, it is the non-concave, or you can call it as convex polygon. These are all about the classification for convex and concave. Then here you have another classification, that is regular polygon or irregular polygon. And it should be equal and the other thing if all angles should be equal, then we can call it as regular polygon. If it is not such like, then we can call it as irregular polygon. The next one, classification of polygons, continuation. It is the classification in the sides, number of sides available and the name given. Polygons are also classified by how many sides they have. The following list are here. A triangle, you know that how many sides are for triangle? 3. And a quadrilateral, it is having 4. This is a quadrilateral. The simplest quadrilateral which we have is a rectangle. Then pentagon. Pentagon has 5 sides. Hexagon has 6 sides. Septagon or heptagon can be called like that. This is known as, this have been 7 sides. Octagon have 8 sides. Nonagon has 9 sides. Decagon has 10 sides. These are all classification for the polygon for sides. Then regular polygons. What is a regular polygon? When a polygon is both equilateral. What is equilateral? All sides should be equal. That is equilateral. And equiangular. What is equiangular? Equiangular means all angles in the polygon should be equal. The all interior angles should be equal. Then it will get equiangular. It is referred to as a regular polygon. For polygon to be regular, it must also be a convex. If it is a regular polygon, it is a convex polygon. These are all regular polygon. All sides are equal, all angles are equal, and these are all convex polygons. Then next one, it is the thing you have studied in the small classes. This is interior add. That means interior, when you are adding the interior angles, then you can get the sum of interior angles of a polygon, that is equal to 10 minus 2 into 180. Then in this chapter, you are not needed to study about for finding all interior angles of all polygons. You have only to find the interior angle of quadrilateral. Then it is having only 4 sides, and if you are having 4 sides, then the answer will be 4 minus 2, that become 2. 2 into 180 degree, then it will become 360 degree. Then sum of the interior angle of a quadrilateral must be equal to 360 degree. Sum of exterior angles of a polygon is always 360 degree. And the sum of interior angles of a polygon can more or less. If it is not a quadrilateral, if its sides are different, then the sum of interior angles must be a different one. Then quadrilaterals. Now we are going to study about quadrilaterals. A quadrilateral is any shape with 4 sides. It should have any shape, but it should have only 4 sides. The word quadrilateral comes from the Latin word quadri, which means 4, and variant of 4, and lateral, which means side. Then 4 sides. It is a quadrilateral. Then properties of quadrilateral: with 4 sides, with 4 angles, with 4 vertices, with 1 pair of diagonals. What is meant by 1 pair of diagonals? That is 2 number of diagonals. Okay. Then next one, it is all about quadrilateral. Quadrilateral is also known as trapezium also. Then quadrilateral can be parallelogram. What is a parallelogram? This side and this side are parallel, and this side and this side. That means opposite sides should be parallel. That are parallelogram. Then trapezium, it is a shape such like an extension. A rectangular piece and an extension of a triangle, it comes trapezium. Right, you know the shape of side. Isosceles trapezium, that means these sides are equal. Then rectangle, square, rhombus. These all are known to you. Then quadrilateral. These are all the things I have explained here in the earlier classes. Triangle, parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square, trapezium, kite. These are all. Then next we are going to find the interior angle sum property, that is angle sum property. Then what is the angle sum property? It is the next what is the answer? 6 minus 3, it is 3. Then 6 into 3 divided by 2. 6, 3 is 18. 18 by 2, that is equal to 9. Then you got the answer as 9. Okay, you can try drawing the diagonal also. Then how many diagonals you can draw? Only 9. A triangle, how many diagonals can be drawn? We can check this one. Discuss the others. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.